I've showed you how to use Ansible to invoke the modules. Ansible comes with about 1800 modules plus, and we've been doing this in a pretty ad hoc imperative way. If you have to follow this, you will probably have to just follow the instructions, but we need to start writing infrastructure as a code, and we have these many tiers or the layers, and for each of this layer, you can apply one or more role. And roles allow you to write that infrastructure as a code, and roles is a package with your code and configurations. And in this example, you're going to have a role for, let's say, Mongo, for cards, for MySQL, for catalog, for Node.js. Some roles will be common as well. So if you look at this common role is for a basic Linux configuration. So you can use that role and apply it to every single node. So a role can be mapped to a layer in your infrastructure, and some roles are just common. If you look at the code here, or any code that you might want to apply, you will find a bunch of roles created. In this case, this is a common role, and the main part of this role is the tasks. So roles contained, so roles map to a layer or a tier, or typically, and roles contain tasks along with the files and templates and variables and a lot of other things, and that becomes part of your role configuration. So for each role, each application, you will create a role, and each of that role can have a similar structure. What changes is the list of tasks that you would apply. For example, in this Ansible directory, we have roles, and we have roles for different purposes, different application. There's one for MySQL, there's one for, and it has a bunch of tasks related to MySQL, and there are roles for other applications as well. And this is an example of a task file, which is again a YAML code. This is the infrastructure as a code. And this is the task file for the common role, which calls for, let's say, a few other, or other task file, because when you call common role, it lands on this main.yaml, and main.yaml has to call other task, conditionally a lot of times. And what you see here is the same module, let's say the package or an APT module within the name and the state. So instead of, invoking it through a command, we are just writing it in the YAML format. Now, how do you write this is you can always go and look at the module index, find out the entity that you want to manage, let's say a user, and then, or APT in this case, that's for installing a package using apt, and you define the name of the package and the state which is present. In addition to that, you can provide any other additional configurations. Again, it's all part of the documentation, and that's what you see here, the name and the state. There's one more property here related to the APT cache here. And then you have variables. So if you look at the package installation, it calls for items, and the items are generally defined as part of the variables. Variables allow you to create different configuration, override that configuration, make it specific to your environment, to your organization, etc., etc. So you have tasks, which are the primary part of the role, and tasks contain each of these is a task which manages an entity, and for managing that entity you call a module. So modules are also called as task plugins, and in this case we are managing a user, installing a, creating a user, defining a package. So whatever steps you need in order to configure an application is what you convert into a task file. And there you call the module, respective module. Let's say for creating a user, you call a user module. For application installation, you create a package module, and so on and so forth. And what goes in task file is the name of the module and the properties and the states. Let's say for, you have four different entities there that you wanted to manage. And some of these are, we are going to use Docker to configure cards.db. For everything else, I already have created commons and cards and MySQL and catalog. So whatever you see there, you will find the roles which are pre-created. Some of these are complete. Let's say common role is complete, front end role is complete. Everything else, let's say catalog and cards, you will have to write two roles. Rest of the roles rather are available to you, which you can apply directly. First, I'm going to show you how to apply these roles to the respective host, and that's where we would start talking about playbooks in the next video.